Ramana Maharshi Center for Learning is a non-profit registered society working now for more than 4 decades in the areas of Indian heritage awareness.
लिख्यते कथम् हृदि कुहमध्ये केवलम् ब्रह्ममात्रम् devotees of Bhagavan had gathered in the shrine. Akka was giving a speech and she was describing the birth of Bhagavan, the birth of Venkata Ramana. The power in the shrine was off, just 2-3 lights and the sound system was kept going by the UPS, otherwise it was dark. Many of us devotees were listening to her with closed eyes, including me. She was describing that a blind midwife who came to help Adagamma deliver the child saw a streak of light. The blind midwife immediately said to Adagamma, "You have got a divine child. You have got a divine being as child." The moment Akka said this, the lights came on in the hall. I was closing my eyes. Just the vision the blind woman would have had, we could all experience. The whole hall went silent. And we rose in applause to Bhagavan, praising him, praising his ever-present grace, informing, "I am here, I am here, I am present, I am present." When Akka gave this topic, I didn't know how to go about it. But as usual, while resting in the corner, the end corner of Bhagavan Samadhi Shrine, totally unexpectedly, three thoughts came. Bhagavan's life is the teaching. All the wondrous events, how they bring out each and every aspect of his teaching by practice and not by word of mouth. Secondly, Bhagavan's life is the teaching. The teaching itself, what do we teach our children after all? We don't describe our whole life to them. This incident, that incident, I dealt with this like this. We introspect over our whole life and tell them the sarams, tell them the essence. Hold on to this. This is what I learned from my life. This is what I teach you. So Bhagavan's life, he is the teaching. But unlike us, he learned everything when he was 16 and a half. And he spent the rest living by the teaching. Teaching us by living. And of course, thirdly, Bhagavan's life is the teaching. What is Bhagavan teaching us? Is Bhagavan the body that was born on 30th December 1879? And that vanished from our vision on 14th April 1950. Obviously not. That too, the greatest of all beings to me that ever walked this earth, that lived between these two dates, that too is not our, that alone is not our Bhagavan. The teachings too, which are going to live forever, the eternal teachings that he has left us, which he has breathed his life into, that too alone is not our Bhagavan. What is he teaching us? Our Bhagavan is the very self. He is the Paramatman. He is the light which is shining within the heart of every being, which is eternal, ever present. And what is he teaching as the self? These three thoughts came to me then. Usually at this time of the year, Uma from our center here would call a few of us devotees with the onerous task of judging the competitions, or so to say, the contributions of school children. As it is the case with every time, she is so kind, and while calling me, she said, "Nandakumar, which do you want to choose? The children, or the middle school, or the high school?" The children are simply great in storytelling. We simply love sitting there, not to judge, just to soak in the stories, just to live Bhagavan's life in their words, in their innocence. When the life of Bhagavan is pictured in that innocent heart, it is simply relived. Yes, it is my feeling that every judge in this panel would love to be there in the room. But I thought I'd be kind for once to Uma and said, "Please allot me anything you want, just to see if everybody is having this same love towards the children's storytelling session." Absolutely, I was correct, because I got only the high school section this time, because obviously somebody else definitely wanted the children's story narration, and it was occupied very soon, and I landed up with the high school segment and middle school segment. What wonderful PowerPoint presentation. The children just relive Bhagavan for us. But is Bhagavan only for children? Is Bhagavan's day-to-day life, what he has lived, is it only for children? Is it a story just to be heard from the child's innocent mouth? No. Bhagavan himself used to narrate stories from great lives, stories from the lives of avatars, stories from the lives of saints. He used to regale audiences. Unless it was sufficient sadhana of teachings, would he ever do that? The Satcharita, the events that have been played out before us by these great beings, just to recall them, is itself a great sadhana. Bhagavan used to regale, Kanakamal writes, he used to regale his devotees. He was available 24 hours, 24/7/365, that is the term that is used now. He used to be available for his devotees all the time, and it appears after dinner he used to regale them with these stories, with this Satcharita. Bhagavan's life is Satcharita, the story of Sat, the story of manifested Sat, which has just appeared to save all of us. He used to narrate to show us that Bhagavan's life is the teaching. It appears he used to start after dinner, and it used to go after 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, late into the night, and the Sarvadhikari was worried about Bhagavan's health. That was his sadhana, perhaps, to worry about Bhagavan's health. But he used to come around, he used to go around in rounds, and he would stop these book reading sessions, or sorry, the story narrating sessions And it appears Bhagavan would be on the lookout. He will be sitting on the bench and the others will be sitting around him. And it appears he will be on the lookout from the windows. And if Sarvadhikari's head is visible, he will tell others, and as soon as Sarvadhikari vanishes, he will say, and start the story. And it appears when Bhagavan narrates, you are very there. Then Bhagavan used to say, Kabir threw up the rope like this, threw up the string like this, and it stood on end to stop that Siddha from displaying his powers. It appears Kabir would be